And on this occasion, I am the moderator of the VLC Indonesian event. We will meet all of you in the next few minutes. So before that, I want to ask, how are you all? And as I always hope you all is to be healthy, and the important things, you must to be happy every day. Why? Because when you happy can make you healthy. And then, okay, di sini I will confess some rules. The first one, teman-teman, aku ingetin lagi buat on cam. Terus jangan lupa menonaktifkan mikrofon. Terus yang ketiga, teman-teman harus banget nih biar makin cantik, makin ganteng, jangan lupa dipakai virtual background yang udah dikasih sama VLC Indonesia. Terus yang terakhir, teman-teman harus banget ngubah nickname nih biar kita saling kenal siapa namanya, terus dari mana, kota asalnya, terus jangan lupa negara. Oke, teman-teman. Nah, aku juga mau say hi lagi sih sama teman-teman yang lain nih biar makin akrab. Aku mau say hi ke... Halo Kak Mugira Al-Fatih, mungkin bisa dengar suara Arta?
Bisa Kak.
Hai, oke. Okay. Arta mau nanya-nanya sama Kak Mugira, boleh nggak?
Boleh.
Nanya nih, boleh. Oke, okay, Arta mau nanya, apa sih yang membuat Kak Mugira nih tertarik banget buat ngikut acara VLC Indonesia ini?
Ya, karena kata dosen saya, ikut-ikut saja, banyak ilmu yang bisa didapatkan dari seminar ini.
Oke, okay. Thank you so much Kak Mugira atas jawabannya. Aku setuju banget sih jawaban Kak Mugira tadi. Kayaknya emang pasti semua orang yang ada di sini berawal dari ketertarikan dulu nih, baru bisa join nih di acara ini. Oke, okay, so terakhir aku mau nanya ke siapa ya? Ke Kak Silviana Putri. Halo Kak Silviana, bisa dengar suara Arta?
Halo, bisa.
Halo. Mungkin Kak Silviana bisa memperkenalkan diri dulu deh, biar kenalan.
Okay. Halo everyone. Nama saya Silviana Putri Ramadianti Siden. Saya dari Universitas Khairun Ternate.
Oke, okay, Arta mau nanya satu pertanyaan nih. Bagaimana sih perasaan Kak Silviana bisa gabung nih dan ikut acara VLC Indonesia ini?
Perasaan saya rasa antusias banget, terus kayak bisa menambah ilmu juga, ketemu teman-teman dari daerah luar, berbagi ilmu, ya kayak gitu.
Oke, okay. Makasih Kak Silviana jawabannya. Salam kenal Kak Silviana. Oke, okay, benar banget sih. Pasti semua orang yang ikut acara ini pasti ngerasa excited banget dong. Apalagi narasumber-narasumber yang didatengin tuh hebat-hebat banget di acara kita kali ini. So, acara selanjutnya nih. Arta mau nayangin video nih. Two video from SMA BPI 2 Bandung, and also the video from our coach. So, mungkin operator bisa bantu Arta nih buat nayangin videonya. Oke, okay, operator. Halo. Oke, okay, bisa kita lihat. Nah. Oke, teman-teman wajib banget enjoy sama video yang ditayangin ini. So, we will start. Mungkin ada kendala nih videonya. Mungkin operator bisa dengar Arta mungkin. Ah. Bisa ditayangin. Katanya
benar-benar lebih itu. Stop 11. Di buku 11.
Hah?
Di buku 11.
Pas. Jadi jangan sampai.
Di 11 juga pas 11.
Oke, mungkin ada kendala mungkin operator buat nayangin videonya. Halo operator. Mungkin operatornya lagi ada kendala nih buat nayangin videonya, cuman kita ini tunggu dulu sebentar ya teman-teman. Biar mungkin teman-teman juga bisa mengenal lebih tahu SMA BPI 2 Bandung tuh seperti apa, terus bisa tahu gimana sih profil dari narasumber kita. Tunggu sebentar ya teman-teman. Orang yang disabar, orang yang sabar disayang Allah. Jadi harus sabar sedikit aja. Nah, okay. Udah ada nih guys, enjoy with this video.
Okay, Google, SMA favorit di Bandung.
Saya merekomendasikan SMA BPI 2 Bandung.
Selamat datang di SMA BPI 2 Bandung, sekolah swasta yang sudah terakreditasi A dan berada di pusat kota Bandung.
Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Baiklah, saya akan memperkenalkan nama saya Dr. Randes Haji Waluya Wahid Utama, Kepala Sekolah SMA BPI 2 Bandung. Keunggulan SMA BPI 2 Bandung baik di dalam bidang akademik maupun non-akademik. Di bidang akademik, SMA BPI 2 Bandung lulusannya banyak diterima di perguruan tinggi negeri maupun di perguruan tinggi swasta ternama. Di bidang non-akademik, SMA BPI 2 Bandung banyak mendapatkan juara tingkat kota, tingkat provinsi, tingkat nasional maupun tingkat internasional. Alhamdulillah, di tingkat internasional SMA BPI 2 mendapatkan medali emas di bidang pencaksilat. Di bidang yang lain, keunggulan SMA BPI 2 yaitu di bidang sarana, di antaranya ruangannya dilengkapi dengan CCTV, dengan AC, internet gratis, serta bangkunya satu orang, satu bangku, dan satu kursi. SMA BPI 2 Bandung dalam pembelajaran BDR ini di masa pandemi COVID-19. SMA BPI 2 Bandung bertatap muka langsung dengan siswanya, yaitu dengan adanya Google Meet dan Zoom Meeting. Kenapa harus memilih SMA BPI 2 Bandung? Karena SMA BPI 2 Bandung ini guru-gurunya sangat menyenangkan, serta lulusannya S1 dan S2. Di SMA BPI 2 Bandung, pembelajarannya sudah menggunakan pendekatan saintifik. Pembelajarannya sudah berbasis revolusi industri 4.0. Di SMA BPI 2 Bandung ada pembelajaran TOEFL, sehingga lulusan SMA BPI 2 Bandung sudah banyak diterima di universitas-universitas luar negeri.
Di eranya normal ini, fasilitas yang menunjang protokol kesehatan sudah diterapkan dengan baik. Program pembelajaran luring dan daring yang aktif, kreatif, serta menyenangkan karena sudah berbasiskan IT. Terdapat program basic English dan tes TOEFL preparation di setiap tingkatan kelasnya. Di tahun 2020, 52 lulusan SMA BPI 2 diterima di perguruan tinggi negeri. Dan selebihnya diterima di perguruan tinggi swasta terbaik di Indonesia. Pengembangan kreativitas siswa didukung dengan berbagai ekstrakurikuler yang memiliki banyak prestasi. mulai dari tingkat kota, provinsi, nasional, sampai internasional. Biayanya pun terjangkau dan fleksibel. Yuk buruan daftar, kuota terbatas. SMA BPI 2 Unggulan, Student Now, Leader Tomorrow.
Ma, aku mau sekolah di BPI 2.
Okay, video selanjutnya ini video dari short profile from the our coach.
Hello everyone, assalamualaikum. I am Coach Joe Mansur, a certified health and life coach who's currently based in California, USA, but I am originally from Malaysia. So I am really excited to be asked by Mr. Bakro and BLC Indonesia to appear as one of the speakers for the Zoomina International event scheduled for the 15th of January 2022. I'm really excited to meet all of you and
mohon maaf teman-teman, mungkin ada kendala dari operatornya. Mungkin bisa dicoba sekali lagi operator buat nayangin videonya.
Hello everyone, assalamualaikum. I am Coach Joe Mansur, a certified health and life coach who's currently based in California, USA, but I am originally from Malaysia. So I am really excited to be asked by Mr. Bakko and BLC Indonesia to appear as one of the speakers for the Zoomina International event scheduled for...
Mohon maaf, mungkin ada yang belum menonaktifkan audionya. Mungkin bisa dinonaktifkan dulu.
Hello everyone, assalamualaikum. I am Coach Joe Mansur, a certified health and life coach who's currently based in California, USA, but I am originally from Malaysia.
Hello, moderator.
Hi.
We have limited time.
Okay.
So you have to continue for the next session. Okay, thank you.
Okay, maybe it's time for watching video earlier. So the next, ada akan... penyampaian gitu dari founder VLC kita nih. Oke, aku mau say hi dulu sama Mr. Bakko. Hai Mr. Bakko, bisa dengar suara Arta? Halo Mr. Bakko. Hai Mr. Bakko.
Ternyata
rak makanya mlebu. Ya, hi too.
Hi, are you happy today?
Yeah, of course, I'm happy.
Are you ready to give the welcome speech?
Yeah, of course. So the first one, actually, I'm still confused. I have to use in two languages, Indonesia and English.
Yes, of course.
Hello, my best coach, Joe Mansur, and Coach Raymond from California. Wow.
Assalamualaikum.
Waalaikumsalam. So let me to say something first. I'm so sorry. Sometimes I have to use in Indonesia because all the participants here, I don't believe that they can speak in English well. But no worries, Coach Joe and Coach Raymond, we have the best translator here from the house. Okay, baik semua buat seluruh sahabat VLC Indonesia, for all the friends of VLC Indonesia. I'm Mr. Bakko as a founder of VLC Indonesia. I want to say thank you so much for coming here for the first meeting on 2022. Yes. Yeah, welcome, happy new year's, happy new year's, and special for my best coach. This is the first time I saw you directly, special for Coach Raymond and Coach Joe Mansur. Wow, nice to meet you. This is
Hi.
A really, yeah. I wanna say big thanks, yeah, because you have a time to join in Indonesia. This is a really social charity in our community. So here's there are participants from all parties Indonesia, because we have 32, maybe 33 provinces Indonesia, I mean in the cities, yes. So buat seluruh sahabat VLC Indonesia, saya berharap, I hope you that you have to stay tuned here until the last time, because after that you can get the electrical certificate. So buat teman-teman atau sahabat VLC, semoga topik hari ini bisa menginspirasi, bisa mengilmui buat kita semua, lalu bisa diaktualisasikan, bisa diaplikasikan buat kehidupan kita masing-masing, bisa diaktualisasikan di sekolah, di rumah, atau di kampus, university, atau doing for around in the working net, ya. Bisa dilakukan di lingkungan kerja juga. Nah, mudah-mudahan juga topik hari ini bisa membuat kita jauh lebih baik setelah mendengarkan dari topik all the speakers, Dr. Frilia. Hello, Dr. Frilia. Nice to meet you. This is the first time too. Jadi Dr. Frilia ini adalah salah satu ahli terkait untuk psikiatri ya, kalau nggak salah ya. Jadi yang bermasalah secara psikis nih, ya siapa tahu ada yang bermasalah secara psikis, hari ini kita bisa cari tahu dari Dr. Frilia. Nah, saya juga berterima kasih buat Coach Raymond and Coach John Mansur. Thank you so much again. Semoga bisa memberikan manfaat buat seluruh all the participants from Indonesia. Nah, buat moderator, saya berterima kasih. Buat host, saya berterima kasih juga. Dan khusus buat kepala sekolah SMA BPI 2 dan tim, saya berterima kasih sebagai founder telah mendukung penuh acara kami yang hadir di setiap bulan. Dan buat seluruh sahabat VLC Indonesia juga, tetap bersama VLC untuk acara-acara berikutnya. Karena setelah ini akan hadir salah satu penulis buku novel terkenal Layangan Putus, insya Allah akan bergabung dengan VLC Indonesia bulan depan. Tetapi kita tidak akan membahas mengenai Layangan Putus, tapi empowering tips and trick how to be empowering person in the world. Sama Dr. Echa Prasetya atau disebut Mami ASF ya kalau nggak salah ya, dan juga salah satu Ustaz Rico Sudirman from Malaysia. Saya pikir cukup. I think enough for Mr. My welcoming speech. Nice to meet you again, Coach Jo, Coach Mansur, and Dr. Frilia. Mohon maaf kalau ada sedikit kekurangan. I'm so sorry if there are a lot of mistake in here or the weakness. I'm so sorry. Stay enjoy with all the participants. Thank you. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Back to moderator.
Warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Thank you so much for Mr. Bako, penyampaian yang luar biasa tadi. Terus kita udah ngeliat juga narasumber-narasumber yang pasti hebat sih buat nyampain materi pada hari ini. So, the next, I will read the biography of the host. We will guide this VLC Indonesia event. So, the first one is, yang pertama ini, hostnya namanya adalah Astin Herzegovina. Wow, namanya susah banget ya guys, lumayan susah sih. Terus bisa juga dipanggil Miss Pina nih, lebih mudah sih dipanggil Miss Pina. Nah, beliau berasal dari Malang, lulusan diploma 3 teknik kimia dari Politeknik Negeri Malang. Wow, teknik kimia yang kita tahu, pelajaran kimia mungkin buat seperti aku nih yang kelas 12 sekarang tuh lumayan susah, tapi beliau bisa lulus ya di teknik kimia. Dan beliau juga seorang English debater dengan 6 tahun pengalaman dan menjuarai kompetisi dengan level regional hingga nasional, terus bisa menjadi best speaker, terus diundang sebagai adjudicator. Dia juga seorang penulis pemula dan blogger. Wow, hebat banget ya. Mungkin kita yang kayak Arta ini suatu saat mungkin bisa meneruskan perjuangan beliau, bisa
menang nih di berbagai kompetisi, apalagi yang kita tahu kompetisi debat tuh pasti susah banget, terus bisa debat dengan bahasa Inggris itu kayak luar biasa sih menurut aku. So yang kedua, I will read the biography of Mr. Rifa. Ini host kedua kita yang aku kagum juga sih, soalnya hebat juga nih. Okay, host yang kedua bernama Rifa Rinaldi atau mudahnya bisa dipanggil Mr. Rifa, dan beliau berasal dari Bandung, lulusan diploma 3 sastra Inggris dari Universitas Pajajaran. Wow, Universitas Pajajaran guys, mungkin teman-teman yang kayak aku nih yang kelas 12 mungkin ada yang pengen juga gitu nerusin studinya gitu ke Universitas Pajajaran. Semoga kita bisa seperti beliau, bisa jadi maba di Universitas Pajajaran. Dan beliau juga mengambil gelar sarjana pendidikan di STKIP Pasundan Cimahi. Dan saat ini juga Mr. Rifa bekerja sebagai guru di SMA BPI 2 Bandung dari tahun 2008 sampai sekarang. Hebat banget guys ya. Yang aku rasa ini menginspirasi gitu buat aku jauh lebih bersemangat lagi biar bisa jadi maba di Universitas Pajajaran. Mungkin aku doain juga teman-teman semuanya bisa mencapai kesuksesannya di jalannya masing-masing ya teman-teman. So, tanpa lama-lama lagi, acara ini bakal Arta serahkan sepenuhnya kepada host-host hebat kita. Siapa lagi kalau bukan Miss Vina dan Mr. Rifa. Oke, waktu dan tempat saya persilahkan.
Oke, tes-tes. Semua bisa dengar suara saya ya. Can everyone hear my voice clearly? Alright. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Good afternoon, selamat siang, dan salam sejahtera bagi seluruh sahabat VLC Indonesia dimanapun Anda berada. And welcome, selamat datang di Zoominar International VLC Indonesia. One teacher, one book, and one thing can change the world. It is an honor to have you all here. Saya Vina, and you can call me Vina. I mean like Miss Vina or Kak Vina, that is also fine. Dan saya yang akan menjadi pemandu acara hari ini, menemani seluruh sahabat VLC Indonesia dalam waktu kurang lebih 1 jam 30 menit ke depan. Dan as you can see on the screen, I am not hosting alone. I have someone accompany me. Kali ini saya ditemani oleh Kak Rifa. Hello Kak Rifa, good afternoon. How are you doing?
Yes, good afternoon Miss Vina. Thank you for asking. I'm very great, thank you. Semoga Kak Vina dan seluruh sahabat VLC Indonesia juga sehat semua. Halo semuanya, welcome to our show. Hi. Perkenalkan, saya Rifa Rinaldi dari SMA BPI 2 Bandung. Bersama Miss Vina akan membawakan acara Zoominar hari ini dengan para expert nih dari Indonesia dan dari California, USA. I'm sure that we all cannot wait to start, right?
Yeah, that's right. So, untuk membuka secara resmi acara kita hari ini, kami mengundang Bapak Waluyo Wahid Utama selaku Kepala Sekolah SMA BPI 2 Bandung untuk memberikan opening remarks and officially starting our event today. Apakah beliau sudah hadir dalam Zoom ini? Bapak Waluyo Wahid Utama. Namanya siapa? Ada tim? Apakah Bapak Waluyo Wahid Utama sudah hadir dalam Zoom ini?
Ya, sudah.
Oke, kepada yang terhormat Bapak Waluyo, kami persilakan.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam
warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Good
morning, good afternoon, and good day to everyone. Welcome to VLC Junior International. I am Muhammad Meryansa, the representative of SMA BPI 2 Bandung. In this short welcome speech, I would like to thank Mr. Bako, the founder of VLC Indonesia, for this beautiful opportunity. Also, I would like to say hello to Mr. Raymond from USA, Dr. Clea Rahma from Indonesia, and Coach Joe Mansur from USA. It's my honor to be here with you all in this seminar, in this seminar. I hope we all have a good time today. To my student, please enjoy this Zoominar International because today we will learn about mental health directly from the expert that in that field. I think this is a great way to start the year. We all have or face this year differently as better person inside and out. It was taboo to talk about mental health, then mindfulness time. Now that we have better awareness in the field, I hope the youth will have better mental development to support their future. We also invite and welcome the parents to learn together with us today. Bapak Ibu and my beloved student, let's enjoy this meeting. That's all from me. Thank you again. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Terima kasih. Terima kasih kepada Bapak Waluyo. Thank you so much for the speech. Now, before we continue, even though Miss Arta at the very beginning of this session already mentioned some rules that you have to follow during the event, we as the host would like to explain or say one more time about the rules. Jadi perlu kami sampaikan sekali lagi beberapa aturan untuk mengikuti Zoominar International hari ini. Yang pertama, dimohon kepada seluruh peserta untuk menyalakan kameranya or turn on your camera selama acara berlangsung. Dan yang kedua, dimohon untuk tidak menyalakan audio or mute your microphone. Jadi berhati-hati dengan microphone. Mari kita jaga sama-sama acara hari ini supaya bisa berlangsung dengan lancar, aman, dan nyaman ya. So be careful with your microphone settings. Let's okay. Go.
Dan yang ketiga, dimohon untuk mengubah nama pada Zoom untuk menuliskan nama asli underscore, nama kota underscore, nama provinsi. Yang keempat, dimohon untuk menggunakan virtual background yang sudah disediakan oleh VLC Indonesia. Dan yang terakhir, daftar hadir akan di-share di chat room 10 menit sebelum acara berakhir. So, we hope for you to stay tuned with us here until the end of the show.
Alright, next kita akan membacakan biografi. We are going to read the biography of each of our incredible guest speakers today. Our first guest speaker is Dr. Filia Rahma Putri, spesialis kejiwaan konsultan. She is from Malang, Indonesia. She is a lecturer at the Faculty of Medicine, Brawijaya University, a psychiatrist, and also consultant of child and adolescent psychiatry. Jadi Dr. Filia ini adalah seorang dosen di Fakultas Kedokteran Universitas Brawijaya Malang, seorang psikiater atau dokter spesialis kesehatan jiwa, serta konsultan psikiatri anak dan remaja.
And our second guest speaker is Coach Raymond King Jr. He is a personal trainer and fitness consultant from California, USA. And ini dari pembicara kedua yaitu Coach Raymond King Jr. Beliau ini seorang personal trainer dan seorang konsultan fitness. And finally, our third guest speaker is Coach Jo Mansour. She's originally from Malaysia, but now based in California, USA. She is a health and life coach and also domestic violence counselor.
All right, now let's move it along. We are going to proceed on to the next agenda. Selanjutnya kita akan menyimak bersama-sama pemaparan materi from each guest speaker. So, masing-masing narasumber kita hari ini will present or share what they already prepared or what they know, what they experience about tema kita hari ini, which is penguatan kesehatan mental di rumah, sekolah, kampus, dan lingkungan kerja. Okay, ready? Kita akan mulai dengan Dr. Filia. We're going to start with Dr. Filia. Hello, Dr. Filia.
Hello, everyone. Good afternoon.
Good afternoon. So
good to be here.
Thank you, Doctor. Can one of the team please put Dr. Filia on the spotlight? Okay, awesome. Gimana kabarnya, Dokter, hari ini? How are you?
I'm good. Thank you so much for asking. Okay. How are you, Mbak Fina, and all of the participants and the committee here?
Yeah, I hope everyone is okay. I'm okay.
I'm fine. Okay too.
Okay, Dr. Filia udah siap ya, Dok, untuk berbagi ilmunya kepada kita semua?
Iya. Yeah. Karena ini adalah talk show, and I hope the moderator or the host can invite me to be interviewed, of course.
Yeah. Okay, Dok. So on this opportunity, Dr. Filia, sebagai seorang medical expert nih di mental health, mohon di-share nih kepada kami semua, Dok, regarding about mental health from medical point of view. Jadi kesehatan jiwa kalau dalam segi sudut pandang medis itu seperti apa sebenarnya? Maybe you can tell us like briefly bagaimana seseorang tuh sampai bisa having a mental health illness or mental health problem. Apakah itu semua hanya kayak di pikiran mereka? Like sometimes kita nggak percaya kalau orang itu having issues on their mental health. Like ah itu paling biasa aja, ah itu paling pura-pura atau gimana or something like that. So what is actually happening about mental health for that kind of person? Dan mungkin selanjutnya bisa briefly juga jelaskan ke kita kalau dalam dunia medis itu menanganinya seperti apa, Dok? Kayak gitu.
Okay. Silakan Dokter Fina. Okay, maybe we can discuss one by one, mungkin Mbak Vina.
First, yes.
I think okay. The first point is about the mental health. If we talk about mental health, it's related to how we can deal with our life, of course, in a good way. Jadi gimana kita bisa mengatasi tantangan hidup? It's been challenging, of course. Kita nggak mungkin akan dapat suatu kondisi yang oke-oke aja. Upside down, dan bisa dibilang kadang-kadang it's been roller coaster, dan kadang mood itu bisa bumping. Tapi dalam
mohon maaf dokter, ke pencet unmute itu mikrofonnya. I'm sorry.
Sorry. Okay. Yeah, if we talk about mental health, it's related to how we can deal with our life, of course, how you can interact to your life in a good way. Nah, in a good way ini kan masing-masing orang itu kan berbeda ya, based on their personality, their defense mechanism. Jadi banyak sekali yang mempengaruhi gitu. Terutama kita berbicara tentang personality kita menghadapi suatu stresor. Kalau misalkan seseorang itu adalah seseorang yang mudah, dalam arti kata they are vulnerable person, maka dia akan cope suatu kondisi atau stresor tersebut itu dengan cara yang nggak adaptif secara adekuat gitu, sehingga the point of view of mental health, of course, about how we can deal in challenging life, of course, gitu kan, dan bagaimana kita bisa berfungsi secara adaptif gitu dalam menghadapi ya. Dari tadi kemute terus ya. Halo
maksudnya automatically commute gitu loh. Yeah.
Yes,
yes.
Okay. Yes, I
maybe one of the team can help set Dr. Filia as co-host. So I think that might be the problem. Yeah, just set all the guest speaker, set semua narasumber hari ini sebagai co-host so they can control themselves to mute or unmute the microphone. Please, thank you. Boleh, silakan lanjut Dr. Filia.
Yeah. If we talk about the mental health, the main point of the mental health is about how we can deal with our life, especially when we can cope stressful event and how we can interact with others in a good way, of course. If we have been dealing in a stressful situation, we can manage in our way. Jadi itu tentunya berkaitan dengan personality, bagaimana cara kita menghadapi tantangan hidup, bagaimana cara kita coping dengan kejadian yang sangat membuat kita stres itu tadi, gitu, sehingga kita bisa berfungsi secara adaptif dalam kehidupan sehari-hari. Seperti itu singkatnya Mbak Vina, poin penting ya dari apa sih sebenarnya mental health itu, gitu, yang supaya kita bisa lebih memahaminya.
Yes, okay. Kalau kita menginjak soal mental health illness, Dok, let's say illness or issue or problem, in medical point of view, is it something like something real or apakah itu biologically issues atau or like what? Sebagai kita sebagai orang yang awam itu kayak ini masalahnya kenapa sih orangnya atau isi kepalanya atau perilakunya atau kenapa sih kok bisa orang itu having different apa ya, having different mentality maybe than others, kayak different behaviors. Ya, itu seperti apa, Dok?
Because everybody has their own personality, their own defense mechanism when dealing stressful event. Yes, for example, misalkan tadi saya bilang bahwa semua orang itu punya kepribadian masing-masing ya, masing-masing berbeda, cara kupnya berbeda. Ibaratnya ketika satu orang dosen atau satu guru gitu, dia berinteraksi dengan muridnya memberikan feedback misal contohnya. Tapi masing-masing person, individu itu kan menyikapinya nggak sama gitu. Ada kepribadian yang cenderung vulnerable gitu ya, dalam masuk kategori vulnerable atau rentan, yang ketika dikasih tahu mungkin mereka akan lebih ih kok gitu sih, kok aku dipermalukan sih gitu. Jadi apa namanya, kayak merasa gurunya itu merendahkan gitu misalkan. Tapi ada juga orang-orang yang justru dengan feedback masukan yang direct itu mereka justru memacu mereka untuk lebih maju gitu. Sehingga mungkin ada yang jatuh menjadi kondisi self-nya itu mengalami defect gitu ya. Tapi ada juga yang self-nya justru lebih cohesive. Jadi enggak bisa kita bicara nearly gitu ya, one aspect gitu. Misalkan kita bicara cuman berdasarkan pada genetik atau pada personality itu sendiri ataupun pada psychosocial stressor. Jadi kita sebut itu sebagai kondisi multifaktorial gitu. Seperti itu.
Oke, kalau gitu sekarang gimana supaya kita masing-masing, as we can see, I think most of us here, most of the participants here are maybe comes from students or teachers or parents. Bagaimana nih cara kita sebagai orang, katakanlah sebagai orang umum ya, Dok, untuk bisa mengetahui atau menyadari bahwa diri kita sendiri saat ini itu apakah kita sudah sehat secara mental, apakah kita butuh bantuan tenaga ahli atau kita mungkin butuh melakukan sesuatu ketika kita merasa ya maybe stress or depressed, bagaimana untuk mendeteksinya untuk diri kita sendiri kayak gitu, Dok.
It's normal, right? If we feel anxious, if we feel depressed or maybe overwhelmed, overburdened, gitu. But the main point is if we can adapt to the situations and we can be functioning in our life, so it will be great for you, of course, as a person. But if you find yourself, if you have difficulties in handling your emotion, so you need to consider to the expert like psychiatrist or psychologist. Jadi paling penting adalah kita mengenali gitu ya, apakah kita bisa mengelola emosi itu sendiri atau enggak. Misalkan kayak excessive mood gitu yang lebih overwhelmed seperti depressive mood or anxiety gitu ya. Nah, ketika itu sudah sangat mengganggu terhadap fungsi sehari-hari, artinya itu merupakan suatu tanda bahwa kita harus mencari pertolongan ke profesional, baik itu ke psikolog ataupun ke psikiater. Ya pasti supaya kita bisa lebih mengenali atau bisa menghandle semua, you must know about your strength and your weakness and try to embrace yourself. Actually, stressing about your weakness. Setiap orang itu pasti kan punya weakness gitu, sehingga kita bisa compensate gitu as a compensation between your strength and your weakness. The first point. Yang kedua adalah how you can try to develop yourself to have an ability to know about someone's position gitu. Jadi maksudnya kemampuan mentalisasi atau suatu kondisi yang kita tuh bisa menempatkan kalau misalkan kita dalam posisi orang itu seperti apa sih. Nah, itu kita jadi lebih bisa mengelola stres kita yang tadinya mau marah, tapi kita, oh ya kalau aku jadi posisi dia, mungkin aku juga nggak enak kali ya, gitu. Sehingga kita nggak jadi marah, gitu. Jadi kita lebih bisa mengelola stres. Dan third point is about boundaries, ya. Kalau kita nggak punya boundaries, maka kita itu jatuh akan menjadi lebih orang yang mudah simpati, gitu. Nah, kalau kita itu it's easy to get sympathized, kita jadi lebih menghabiskan energi gitu dan juga pikiran, sehingga perlu sekali kita tuh menetapkan boundaries bahwa ini adalah saya dan masalahmu adalah masalahmu gitu. Tetapi tidak berarti being selfish, ignore gitu ya orang lain dan jadi self-centered gitu, sehingga kita juga bisa menempatkan diri kita tetap dalam posisi memahami apa yang di rasakan oleh orang lain gitu, sehingga jatuhnya adalah bentuk-bentuk empati bukan simpati. Itu adalah poin paling penting agar kita bisa mengelola diri kita dan tidak jatuh dalam keadaan stres gitu.
Oke, itu juga ini ya dok, berlaku juga buat seandainya kita dalam sudut pandang si orang lain ini, ketika kita melihat mungkin orang-orang sekitar kita dari keluarga, teman, atau mungkin rekan-rekanan kerja kayak something wrong with them, kayak they have their changing of their behaviors, karena mungkin ada perubahan perilaku dan sebenarnya itu kita ingin membantu, ingin kayak helping them, like what is wrong with them, kayak kita concern tentang mereka, itu juga kita harus knowing our own boundaries first before we can maybe offer our help to them atau offer ya our guides to them gitu ya dok ya.
Yes, of course, and you need to make assure ya kalau kamu itu adalah seseorang yang memang cukup sehat jiwa gitu untuk menjadi seorang rescuer gitu. Sehingga kalau kita sehat jiwa pasti kita bisa menolong. Tapi kalau misalkan kita sendiri sedang tidak baik-baik saja, how can you help someone else gitu. Jadi pastikan bahwa we are ready to help and mentally health gitu.
Oke. Kalau ini dok, mungkin banyak yang bagaimana caranya supaya masyarakat umum tuh tidak khawatir atau tidak takut-takut atau tidak sungkan-sungkan untuk go to the expert if you need help. Kayak mungkin masih ada yang aduh nanti dikasih obat, aduh nanti harus ngobrol lama-lama, harus mungkin mahal lah apa gimana. What is it like actually, dok? What is it like actually?
Yeah, it's normal. Jadi if you go to psychiatrist, you automatically think that, oh, the psychiatrist must give you or must give me a medication. And I don't need to be medicated because I just wanted to talk and to solve my problem with that medication. But don't worry, because psychiatrist knows that if you don't need the medication, there is no indication, you won't be given the medication. Trust us, okay? Yes, medication can help you, of course, especially to stabilize the neurotransmitters, the imbalance of the neurotransmitter in your brain. So that's why it will work on your brain and it will affect to your behavior. But it's not only about the medication itself, but we need also like psychotherapy. So the psychiatrist will give you the combination between the psychotherapy and pharmacology. It will help you. And the psychiatrist will train you to cope, how to be adaptive person so you can be functioning in your life. So don't worry when you go to the psychiatrist, you will be stigmatized, because if you stigmatize yourself, it will affect your self-confidence. So think that when you go to a psychiatrist, you try to solve your problem. You are in good condition, but you want to be better when you go to the psychiatrist. So jadi kalau misalkan kita psikiater, yang pasti harus ditanamkan dalam mindset kita adalah kita nggak harus sehat, enggak, kita enggak harus gila gitu. Tapi ya kita udah already sehat jiwa dan akan jauh lebih sehat lagi kalau kita berkunjung atau mengunjungi atau mencari pertolongan ke expertnya gitu. Itu mindset yang mesti diubah mulai sekarang gitu.
Okay. Yes, agree. Jadi hanya dengan kita menilai bahwa diri kita sendiri itu perlu pertolongan dan kita bertindak mencari pertolongan, itu sebenarnya menunjukkan bahwa inherently we are still a healthy person, mm-hmm. right? Yeah. Mm-hmm. Okay. Terima kasih Dr. Filia atas sharingnya. So your 15 minutes is almost up. Thank you very much. And
thank you.
Yeah, thank you Dr. Filia. I hope you can stay with us here until the end of the show. Hopefully, yeah. Okay. Thank you again once more. Let's now moving on to the next speaker. Siapakah selanjutnya? Silakan Kak Rifa.
All right, everyone. Our next speaker is Coach Raymond King Jr. Hello, Coach Raymond. How are you doing?
Assalamualaikum. I'm doing great.
Alhamdulillah. Alhamdulillah. Okay.
We actually want to co-present.
Yeah. We didn't know that you both will be on the same screen.
The same screen.
Yeah. What a surprise. Hello. Okay. Go on, Kak Rifa.
Okay. So, Coach, how are you feeling to joining with VLC Indonesia?
What was the question?
How are you feeling?
I feel good. I'm the live.
Okay. Are you ready? Yeah. Are you ready? Are you ready to share your expertise to all of us?
Yes. Inshallah.
Inshallah. Okay. Okay. Coach Raymond, you get 15 minutes, and you are welcome to start now. The stage is yours.
Okay. Give me a second. I am trying to get to our slide.
Okay. Oh, you're using your slides?
Yeah, just a short one.
Okay, awesome. Can you share it?
So the question.
No, that one is later. Hold on.
Would you like to share the slides by yourself, Coach Raymond, or maybe one of the team, one of our team from VLC can help?
Do you want to just talk then?
Yeah, I'm just going to talk a little bit about just fitness in general and strength training, you know, and what it does for me. Today, for example, I do a lot of strength training. I strength train about 6-7 days out of the week. So what it teaches me is to be calm under pressure. Like, for example, I was doing a back squat with about 300 pounds on my back. And you're getting that weight is on you. And initially you want to kind of panic. Oh man, this is heavy. So mentally it tells me, you know what? You're going to be okay. Stay calm, form, technique. And that puts me in the present moment. So all distractions and all my problems, I might think about, I'm just thinking about getting this weight up. So what that does is mentally it engages me in the present, knowing that, you know what? I'm going to be fine. And be okay. I think everybody should do hard things every day, whether it's strength training, it's hiking, doing something uncomfortable. You know, that way you build resilience, you know, you build confidence. And you know, and think about it, Allah wants us to be strong. He don't want us to be weak. So I look at strength training as a form of meditation, almost like Salat, you know, it puts you in the present moment, you know, combine the physical with the spiritual and the mental. And also too, when you build muscles through strength training, guess what? You burn calories while you're resting. So a person, each pound of muscle you have in the body, you burn 9 calories per pound of muscle. Each pound of fat, 4 calories. So I encourage people to do strength training so you can kind of get away. You have some cake and it won't affect you. It go to your muscles versus your fat. So I tell people, do something hard every day. And sometimes, if you don't know strength training, okay, I tell people, take a cold shower. You know, it gets you that, ooh, it's cold. But you know what? Let me relax. You know, I'm going to be fine. You know, Allah will get me through this. They teach you not to panic, especially in this world where we got so many different distractions, where people panic. When the first thing comes at them, they get worried. But if you focus, stay present, listen to your body, and tune out all the distractions, you realize you'll be fine.
Okay. So I think what you mean, this mental and physically must be maintained and equally.
Yes.
Is that right,
yes.
Sir? Okay.
Yes.
So in every daily life, I mean.
Yes. And you got to do something every day.
This every day.
You know, in this society we live in, everything is so convenient. You get your phone, you order food, work from home, you know, and
yeah.
Everything's so easy. And yeah. Easy doesn't translate to being good for you. You know, in this world, this goodness, the phones and stuff and social media is actually bad for us. It's making us weaker as a society and causing more anxiety and more depression. Mm-hmm. And we lose connection with ourselves and with Allah because of these. Of the technology, unfortunately, you know. Yeah. So people gotta get back to doing physical things and connecting. Like for example, we mix a lot. We sujood, we pray, we bow, we bend, and that physical connects us with Allah. We just don't sit there and just or look at our phone, but the physical connects with the spiritual. And then we're blessed as Muslims that we have that. You know, black people don't have that. And like you said, the mental with the physical is so important, which would translate with the spiritual.
Yes, also the spiritual must be maintained, balanced, and equal also.
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah. Okay. I think for us, we believe that there's three components to it, right? There's exercise, nutrition, as well as rest or spiritual or meditation, right? So that's important in order to get that life balance. So we've talked a little bit about the importance of exercise. Then, you know, we can also bring up nutrition, where we need to have, you know, we need to eat real food, right? Things that grow instead of things that comes in packages, oh, right? Well, that's where all the vitamins and nutrients are from. And then of course, we need to drink lots of water because sometimes you think you're hungry, but in actual fact, you're actually thirsty. And when you drink water, that helps your body flow better, work better, right? Kind of like the car. If you don't give it the proper oil, the oil change and all that, you don't maintain it, it'll break yes. down. Same with our body as well. You want to talk about
mm-hmm. the protein? Yeah, and add with the whole foods. So for example, you have an apple, you eat it. It gives you a sense of fullness, satiety. You eat it. Oh, I'm full. You know, it's hard for a person to eat two apples. You like one is like you're enough. Now you have a bag of chips or some cookies. You eat, and you don't get a sense of fullness. You just keep eating, and you don't eat 2,000 calories, and you don't feel full at all. Whereas versus whole foods, it gets your mind. Oh wow, I'm full because it's a whole food. You know, and the same thing, you have protein, like, for example, you have some chicken. Chicken, you know, it's, you know, you don't get full of a piece of chicken or mm-hmm. some steak. I never seen a person eat two pieces of steak. You know, like, oh, man, I'm full. Now, rice, pasta, you can keep eating it, you know. But with protein, it gives you that fullness. And unfortunately, as we get older, you know, we don't get our protein needs met. And so I think we need to increase our protein as we get older, so we can help build our muscles and with our hormones and our brain versus, you know, carbs are good, but I think we should prioritize protein as we get older, because those are the building blocks of muscle, and that's what's going to keep us youthful and not aging where we don't have no strength to do anything.
Okay, thank you, Coach. Well, like PLC Indonesia, paparan dari Coach Raymond Junior bahwa di sini bahwa secara mental fisik itu seharus selaras gitu. Ketika kita mindset kita bahwa oh itu sesuatu yang tidak bisa, tetapi itu bisa gitu. itu secara secara mindset tidak bisa, tetapi ketika kita berusaha terus pasti akan tercapai. Nah, begitu juga ketika menghadapi tantangan, when we are facing the challenging of the world, kita menghadapi tantangan dunia nih, bagaimana kita menghadapinya, bagaimana kita mensiasatinya gitu. Kalau mindset kita ya tidak bisa, ya tetap tidak bisa gitu. Tapi kalau kitanya bisa apa melakukannya pas, secara spirit dan fisik pasti bisa. Okay. Thank you Coach Raymond. Jadi for your explanation ya. Kavina, silakan.
Okay, is there anything else would you like to add, Coach Raymond?
I'd like to just add this, the importance of habits. Mm-hmm. You know, set habits for yourself every day. You know, like I said, we're blessed to have Islam and to have our Salat to give us these habits. And mm-hmm. I think we need to do the same thing with exercise and with food, you know, and not to do a whole lot, but do a little bit every day, just a little bit. And the little things add up to big things, you know, mm-hmm. and the importance of doing habits. If you're going to walk, walk for 10 minutes a day. Mm-hmm. You got to be an hour, just 10 minutes, just a little bit. And that 10 minutes will add up.
Yeah, longer. Yeah. So, you know, so or, that's a great way to start, right? Start small, but do it constantly, right?
Exactly. Or if a person drink a lot of soda, like, know what? I'm just not going to drink soda, you know, or let me add, you know, have a salad for one part of the day and just make it a goal and just be consistent. And then you can start slowly adding things or eliminating things. Can you eliminate things that adds value to you too? When a person eats for a person eats cookies, know what? I'm not gonna eat cookies for this week, you know, okay. Yeah. And then next week, slowly, gradually subtract.
I could talk about these kind of things like all day long. I'm working on that.
Maybe, and, yeah. Maybe yeah, something, maybe doing small thing, which is related to our body is very important, right, Coach?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes. And also, I want to add that it is important to have, you know, to have downtime, right? No, you have recovery, rest and recovery is very important because, you know, you have to have boundaries. Boundaries are very important. I used to work in the hotel industry before I became a coach. And there were no boundaries, you know, we were given a cell phone and the client and the boss can call us any time of the day, 24/7, we're on call. And that's not good because even when you're sleeping, if there's a problem at the hotel, they'll call you. And that's not good for my mental health, right? So it was not good. You need to have boundaries. You need to have, you have to have limit, right? And then schedule some downtime, to log off from the internet, log off from electronics, turn off your cell phone. And also don't get caught up with social media. You know, you see people like Kim Kardashian and, and whoever has all these fantastic things, you know, fantastic to other people, I don't think so, but, you know, don't get caught up in all that. You know, lead a simple, good, healthy life.
Okay.
Baik, mungkin dari kesimpulannya bahwa kita tuh harus punya batasan ya, Kavina ya, batasan untuk apapun gitu. Maksudnya tidak terlalu bergantung kepada gadget atau sosial media gitu, atau bahkan rutinitas sehari-hari gitu. Bahkan kita harus ini juga meluangkan waktu juga, bahkan mempunyai batasan juga gitu. Kita harus mempunyai batasan, boundaries, as Coach Joe say, that boundaries, we have the boundaries in any kind of life, gitu. Maybe, Kavina, do you want to add something? Please?
Okay, I am curious about one thing, though. Is there anything such as doing it too much? Is there anything such as doing it too much? Like being very concerned about what we eat, that can lead to some kind of eating disorder or something, right? Or maybe we are too concerned of having
or having fulfilled our daily exercise targets, for example, that can lead to some kind of imbalance, I think, right? What do you take on that? What are your take on that, Coach Raymond or Coach Joe?
Well, the shaitan, you know, tells us more is better. Uh-huh. You know, Allah tells us, like, if I gave man, you know, two sons, he want a third son. If I gave him four sons, he want a fifth.
Yeah.
So I think it's important to realize having balance and looking at the bigger picture, realizing I'm using fitness, nutrition for my health. I'm not trying to be Superman, mm-hmm. you know, but I want to live a long, balanced, healthy life where we can be good functioning Muslims in society. And that's tough because, you know, we get in a habit, we like something, we go. And, mm-hmm. and it's very important to be mindful. Even for myself, sometimes I push a little bit, but I've been doing this for a long time. I kind of know, okay, no, I'm doing too much. Now, and you can tell how you feel, like if you're not sleeping correct, you're not getting no sleep at night. You know, you might be a little more anxious, you know. So those things kind of you can see if you're doing too much. You know, you're feeling more tired, a little more weak, you know, you're less productive, you're more irritable. Those are signs people should look for if they're overdoing it. You know, you just like you have no appetite sometimes. You know, or you might more have appetite because you're doing so much. Mm-hmm. And it's just things people got to be more conscious of and listen to their bodies, you know, which we don't do enough of in a society where we just go, you know, and sometimes we got to slow down to go faster, you know. So you slow down, listen to your body, and you can, okay, let me, you know, step back. Myself professionally, I like helping people. And sometimes I might overdo it. I'm training too many clients and I feel my productivity kind of drops a little bit with my fitness as well as my clients. So I tell myself I got to back off and not take on so many clients because it affects my sleep. My energy is low, you know? So I tell myself, no, I got to back off. I'm doing too much, you know? But that comes with, you know, it came a lot of time for me, years of
practice
and failing to realize that, you know?
Oke, jadi gimana para peserta VLC hari ini? Sudah pada garu-garu kepala? Sudah pada bingung? So check it easy everyone. Jadi tadi yang disampaikan oleh Coach Raymond adalah banyak sekali ya, seperti yang tadi juga sudah diringkas oleh Kak Rifa. Dan yang barusan tadi adalah yang disampaikan bahwa kadang-kadang kita itu karena saking inginnya mencapai suatu target, kita kayak melakukan hal-hal yang kita lakukan itu terlalu berlebihan. So like we don't understand our own mechanism, our own body. Kita terlalu berlebihan dalam melakukan olahraga. Kayak misalnya biasanya kalau orang yang nggak biasa olahraga nih, for example, you can start slow, you can start easy, like doing walking every day. Gak bisa kalau langsung tiba-tiba angkat 45 kilo. Like that is some kind of difficult things to do. Dan kalau toh kita sudah dalam kondisi yang kita sudah melakukan itu secara reguler dan kita ingin push, ingin terus lanjut, that is actually an alert, like that's actually the signal, yeah, when you have to slow down.
Yeah.
So and it's like
I just want to add, you don't have to join a gym, right? You don't have to spend money to get a gym membership. Oh, right, dear. So if you are at your office building or at the university, just leave the lecture room and just walk around the parking lot. Walk around the parking lot, yeah. 10 minutes.
Or walking, you know, the stairs up and down.
Yes, up and down. Park your car further away and then walk. You know, it doesn't. Being healthy doesn't have to be expensive.
Yes.
Or extreme.
Let me add one thing. So every new year, everybody's these goals. I want to lose 100 pounds. I want to run this. And so everybody goes 100 miles an hour beginning of the year. Working out. And then after about a month, oh, this is too hard. I can't do it no more.
Can't maintain it.
You know, and the problem is they did too much at one time, which means burnout. But it just did a little bit, you know, it's a little bit. and gradually build up, they'll be fine. But most people, like you said, they burn out because they do too much at one time and it's not sustainable. You know, the body is good at letting us know, like, it's just too much. I got to go easy, easy. So people better off set small goals. Like I said, a 10-minute walk a day versus like an hour a day, you know.
Yeah, okay. So it's, I think we're moving on this to Coach Joe, right? So,
yes.
No, so
we're all together.
Is that it? Okay, then I'm going to continue my timers until your both combined 30 minutes is up then.
Okay, that's fine.
Okay. So it's funny how, it's interesting how you mentioned about burnout. Maybe aside from diet and exercise and health, burnout is also can happen in our daily activities, like in our job, in our educations, as students, as teachers, as or other professions. I think I would like to move to Coach Joe. Yeah, Kak Rifa?
Yes.
We're going to move to Coach Joe. What do you think about that, Coach Joe? So how do someone realize that they are, or he or he is currently having a burnout, like in their daily activities, in their daily lives?
I think when you no longer love what you're doing, you know? Mm-hmm. So like example, you, like what Raymond said, beginning of the year, you are happy, you go to the gym every day, you go, go, go. And then 2 weeks down the road, you're like, oh, I don't want to get up anymore. I don't want to do this anymore. You know, because then you are, and then the passion, the joy turns into the, oh, you're dragging your feet. You know, do I want to get out of bed? So that's burnout. You're heading towards that. You know, just like in our work, I told you I used to work in the hotel industry, right? So that was what happened. At first I was, we call it what, gung-ho. We're very happy to go to work, excited. And then after that, when you work so many hours, you get burnt out and you don't want to do it anymore. You're like, no, I'm done. So the same with, you know, students or even mothers, right? We are tired, we have so many kids and we are burnt out and we need help. So students have to be careful of that too. Just make sure you balance it so that you don't get burnt out. You know, don't, so when you study, right? You study in a semester, study, study, study. You don't play, 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 play and then study. You know, you don't study, you don't cram it in within 1 week before the exam. You have the whole semester to be consistent. So it's all about consistency, but at the same time, balancing it, finding joy in what you do so that you still, you know, you still maintain the passion, right? Instead of just, I think balance is very important.
Yeah.
In other words, I have a old saying, consistency over intensity. Yeah.
Itu jadi gitu Kak Rifa, gimana selama ini sebagai guru, Kak Rifa nih sebagai guru di SMA BPI 2 Bandung, pernah nggak kayak ngerasa tired, exhausted, like having to teach every single day, like maybe even if you're not teaching you also have some work to do, right? Like you preparing your materials and stuff. So that is the maybe you can share to everyone apa tadi yang disampaikan oleh Coach Joe, gitu kan, bisa bermanfaat ya.
Yeah, as a teacher, the kind of burden. Sometimes I have some burden. Well, what should I teach to my students? And then and the pressure of the the headmaster or maybe how to dealing with my students. But yeah, alhamdulillah, I just say that let it flow. It's and take it easy when teaching, and also like giving ice breaking first. And then knowing them, and then see what they want from this material. What do you want to be in this material, for example? Itu. Yeah, I think.
Yes? Can you share? Can you share us? Can you share that in bahasa maybe.
Oh yeah.
So all of our fellow Indonesia.
Oh, yeah. Oke, okay, sorry. Jadi gini, kalau saya sebagai guru bahasa Inggris,
yeah.
Ya let it, sebagai guru ya, ya let it flow aja. Gitu maksudnya. Oh. Let it flow dalam artian harus ini ya, maksudnya harus kalau umpamanya ada pressure dari atasan atau umpamanya dari from coworkers, saya harus apa ya, harus ya mencoba apa ya, let it go lah gitu, mencoba ikhlas, try to be ya apa, ikhlas untuk iya, untuk apa ya, untuk ya ini supaya tidak menjadi ini juga kepikiran gitu. Kalau untuk murid, kalau saya mengajar itu biasakan dengan ini dulu, dengan apa, ice breaking dulu. Ya, jadi memberikan apa, hal-hal yang kecil dulu gitu, menanyakan keseharian mereka seperti itu. Baru ini mau mengajarkan mau materi apa dan apa sih yang ingin dia dapat dari materi ini seperti itu. Begitu Kak Vina.
Oke, okay, awesome. So we get a lot from all of our incredible guest speakers, yeah, and they're both combined duration of
yes, the combined material. Duration.
They both combined duration is actually almost up. Kak Rifa, I know we planned on giving each of them questions before
yes.
before we give the opportunity to all the participants, but I think karena dari awal kita sistemnya really really literally like talk show.
Iya, betul,
right?
Betul.
So jadi di sini supaya kita lebih interaktif, how about we move it to Q&A session from yes. participants, right?
Betul, betul.
I think it will be very interesting. Karena pasti kita yakin nih dari semua pasti banyak yang ingin bertanya, banyak yang ingin ya minta-minta saran gitu ya Kak Rifa, bagaimana betul. Pendapat Kak Rifa?
Ya. Baik. Baik, mungkin kita langsung ke Q&A ke ini ya, ke coach ke atau ke langsung ke peserta nih Kak.
I think it will be better langsung ke peserta because
okay.
or us let me check my question list or if there is still a question that we haven't covered before with our narasumber, kalau ada pertanyaan yang belum tercover jawaban-jawabannya dengan percakapan kita dengan narasumber sebelumnya, we can ask them.
Iya, mungkin saya bisa bertanya ke Dr. Frilia mungkin ya.
Sure.
Iya. Halo, Dok.
Yes, halo. Bisa,
iya.
Yes, halo.
Baik. Iya, Dokter, saya mau bertanya nih baik. Begini pertanyaannya, Dok. Kalau saat ini kita ketahui bahwa maraknya perilaku self harm ya, kebanyakan ya dibanyak oleh remaja nih atau dewasa, dan mungkin bahkan anak-anak juga tidak menutup kemungkinan. Nah, sebenarnya apa sih yang menyebabkan ini ya, self harm itu kan seperti melukai diri sendiri ya, Dok. Nah, ini triggernya apa sih kalau boleh tahu?
Oke. Ini kita jawab di bahasa atau gimana?
Bahasa boleh, bahasa Inggris boleh.
Boleh.
Sama campur aja. Gado-gado aja dong.
Kita bertiga sama-sama bingung.
Oke. Oke. Iya. Ini sekarang lagi sering banget ya kasus-kasus self-harming behavior gitu. Sehingga sebenarnya sih apa sih yang membuat orang itu mengalami self-harm? Banyak banget. Tadi yang satu disebutin oleh coach gitu ya, para coach itu adalah, atau Mbak Vina tadi juga mention about burnout. If we talk about, before I explain about self-harm ya, yeah, the first etiology or the first cause is related about burnout. We know that burnout is a state of emotional, physical, and mental exhaustion caused by prolonged and excessive stress, and it occurs when you feel overwhelmed, like mentally drained, and you cannot or you unable to meet constant demand. Nah, tadi yang disampaikan juga oleh coach bahwa terkait dengan inconsistency gitu. Nah, ketika seseorang itu sudah sangat mentally drained, itu they cannot cope gitu kan. Jadi they don't have ability to manage the stress. Nah, self-harm is a part of behavior that can release your emotion, like painful emotion, painful feeling gitu. Jadi sehingga kalau kita lagi stres, dia dialihkan ke burnout, ke kok jadi burnout, dialihkan ke self-harm. Inilah kalau misalkan kita harus udah bahasanya harus ganti-ganti ya. Jadi ada konsep di sini.
Betul.
Harus ada subtitle. Kalau jelasin pakai bahasa Inggris udah langsung terus gitu ya. Begitu udah pindah-pindah bahasa Indonesia ini udah agak konslet nih. Nah, jadi ketika orang itu self-harm gitu, akhirnya dia kan berusaha untuk rilis perasaan gitu. Untuk rilis perasaan itu dengan cutting misalkan, for example, itu kan feel-nya kan oh my god, it's so good gitu to feel the emotion because they cannot feel attracting. Nah, orang-orang yang melakukan self-harm itu dia nggak bisa merasakan rasa sakit itu. Kalau sakitnya di sini, nah itu dia berusaha untuk dapat sakitnya tuh di sini gitu ya, katanya cita-cita. Nah, itu tuh mereka akan sangat feeling better gitu doing self-harm. So self-harming behavior is a one of behavior that can release your emotion and to release your painful emotion. Jadi satu hal yang rasanya menyakitkan itu diarahkan kepada perilaku self-harm itu sendiri. Nah, itu cara-cara mengapa orang melakukan self-harm, dan biasanya itu di-induced by yang self-image-nya itu blur. Jadi kalau misalkan self-image-nya itu blur, dia kabur gitu. Dia nggak punya tuh self-image-nya jelas gitu. Dia nggak ngerti siapa sih aku, who I am, what I want to be. Itu mereka nggak tahu gitu. Sehingga kadang-kadang sesuatu itu mereka tuh butuh yang lebih faktual, yang lebih real, yang lebih eksis gitu. Sehingga akhirnya mereka melakukan self-harm itu. Dan personality yang seperti itu pas vulnerable gitu. Jadi kan ada vulnerable trait yang menginduce mengapa mereka sampai melakukan perilaku self-harm itu. Seperti itu, Mr. Riva.
Iya, terima kasih dokter. Oke, nah kita mungkin langsung ya Kak Vina.
Betul.
Untuk para sahabat VLC ini udah nggak sabar nih, ingin bertanya. Yeah. Baik, VLC ini, para sahabat VLC Indonesia, kalian bisa raise your hand, kemudian unmute your mic ya, untuk mengirimkan pertanyaan di kolom chat. Oke.
Oke, jadi sekarang kita masuk pada sesi tanya-jawab di mana peserta seluruh sahabat VLC Indonesia dipersilahkan untuk mengajukan pertanyaan baik secara langsung maupun di chat room. So you can have your chance to ask a question. This is a very, very rare opportunity. So use this kalau misalkan ada yang mau bertanya, ada yang mau ingin sharing cerita or something, asking from our experts' opinions, you can do that now. Kita sudah ada 2 partisipan di sini yang raise hand. So, jadi Kak Rifa dan saya akan take turns ya. Kita akan bergiliran.
Iya.
Kita akan bergiliran memandu, mengizinkan dan memberikan apa, membantu mengkomunikasikan pertanyaan-pertanyaan itu kepada para narasumber kita hari ini. So, I'm going to start with Ibu Roswita Abu. You can unmute your mic. Okay, great, awesome. Halo, Bu Roswita.
Halo, apa kabar? Dan selamat siang semuanya. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Baik, Ibu, ingin bertanya kepada siapa, Bu Roswita?
Baik, kepada dokter.
Oh, sebelumnya, Bu Roswita dari mana dulu, maaf?
Sorry, saya dari Universitas Hairun, Ternate, Maluku Utara.
Oh, wow. Oke. Ya, silakan.
Baik, iya. Mungkin saya sedikit menyampaikan dulu beberapa keterkaitan antara mental health yang sudah tadi disampaikan oleh Dr. Prilia, kemudian dilanjutkan dengan pentingnya bagaimana kita membalancing kehidupan pribadi kita dalam hal maintaining our mental health through exercises, ya, mungkin exercises and also food. Saya ada punya 3 peran di sini. Saya sebagai orang tua, I'm the parents of 4 sons. Saya juga mahasiswa, saya sebentar lagi studi pasca sarjana. Kemudian saya juga seorang pengajar, teacher, jadi saya punya 3 peran di sini. Bagaimana membalans sehingga saya masih sampai saat ini mental health saya masih baik-baik saja.
Alhamdulillah.
Jadi tiga peran ini yang kalau misalnya bisa kita maintain secara balance, secara proper, maka insya Allah kita masih sehat panjang umur. Mungkin itu yang bisa juga diketahui oleh adik-adik mahasiswa. Nah, beberapa kasus terakhir di tahun kemarin itu ada kasus yang memang bukan self-harming lagi, tetapi memang sudah commit suicide, jadi sudah bunuh diri. Mohon maaf, karena ini kita bicara tentang mental health. Dan kasusnya ini ternyata bukan hanya di satu kalangan. Jadi ada case-nya mahasiswa, ada case-nya pekerja. Ada pekerja. Kemudian ada case juga keluarga muda. Keluarga muda. Nah, jadi kasus ini yang mungkin kita lihat dia tidak secara satu grup atau satu kelompok, misalnya mahasiswa semua tidak, tetapi ternyata bervariasi. Dan ini penting. Nah, kalau saya sendiri mungkin saya sedikit share overload dari pekerjaan di kampus ataupun misalnya di rumah. Saya punya 4 anak laki-laki yang mana setiap hari ketika saya harus mengatur mereka, mungkin kadang-kadang saya harus mengeluarkan suara saya yang powerful untuk seriosa, misalnya to discipline them, ya. But it's not quite hard. Tidak terlalu sulit untuk mengatur anak-anak di rumah maupun di kampus. Saya mungkin dalam satu minggu mengajar hampir 100 mahasiswa di 5 kelas. Jadi bisa dibayangkan. Tapi that's not a problem at all. Bukan masalah sama sekali. But sometimes saya punya overload dengan kegiatan-kegiatan yang lain. Kemudian how to cope with that? Kadang-kadang saya punya me time. Saya punya waktu tersendiri. Saya tidak harus. I don't have to go with my kids. I don't have to go with my husband. I don't have to go with my friends. But I have my me time. Saya punya waktu tersendiri untuk duduk ngopi-ngopi sekedar 30 menit, makan apa begitu, ataupun mungkin nonton film. Nonton film kemudian saya nangis-nangis sendiri, and that's fine. Besoknya saya udah mulai berenergi lagi untuk bekerja. Seperti itu. Jadi kemudian maybe 3 times in a week I have an aerobic class, Coach Raymond and Coach Joe. I have aerobic class, so I enjoy, even though it's not always the target, because I don't want to feel, oh, I have to reach a target of 50 kilograms. No, it's not my target. My target is that I just want to feel healthy. Yeah, something okay. Like that. So, okay. I just want to feel healthy and I just want to be happy, something like that. So, if I feel like I have some target, then I will be burned out. Yeah.
Okay, yeah.
Yeah, something like that. So, I feel like I enjoy myself, even though that there's a lot of work, there's a lot of assignment to do. There's a lot of things that I have to think of, maybe not today but tomorrow, and there's a lot of things happen around us in work, at house, or something like that. And the experience that I have, it should be maybe some of the student or some of you or the participant feel that it is that's effective for you to apply that, maybe. I just want to ask for Dr. Filia, how about having our time by ourselves, it's something positive or something like that. And also to Coach Raymond and to Coach Joe, sorry, I have an aerobic class, but I'm also a good baker. Saya sering masak di rumah, apapun yang saya inginkan, kalau saya lagi stuck, saya masak, I cook something which is very, very full of cholesterol, chocolate, something like that, but I enjoy that.
Thank you, Bu Roswita. So basically, Bu Roswita just share
her whole life story. She just shared her whole life story, how she is a teacher or lecturer, how she is a mother, how she is also a student, and despite all of her busy days, she still have me times, which is something that she prefers to do in terms of keeping her own mental health rather than going out with people or with her peeps. She prefers some me times by watching movies and cooking and baking, and that is actually something that agreeable with to all of us, right? Yeah, thumbs up. Okay, we have many more other questions from the participant. Thank you, Ibu Roswita. Let's move to our next pertanyaan. Let's go, Pak Rifa.
Baik, we are going to continue. Kita masih masih melanjutkan sesi tanya jawab nih. Ini saya ambil dari chat Deis, Ibu Deis Ningsih, betul? Nah, ini saya, I'm afraid this is in bahasa. Apa yang harus dilakukan jika perasaan atau mental seseorang kadang-kadang naik turun, terkadang bisa dengan mudah marah kepada seseorang dan dengan mudah lagi tersenyum kepada seseorang tersebut dalam waktu yang sama. Dan mental yang seperti ini bisa, apakah bisa berbahaya? Okay.
I think this one best to be answered maybe, I think, by Dr. Filia. So what if someone having up and down mood, like the question leads implies like up and down mood, but it's pretty extreme. Is it healthy, like, or not?
Yeah.
Gimana, dokter?
Kalau mood, yes, okay. Karena pertanyaan di bahasa Indonesia, mungkin kita jawab di bahasa Indonesia dulu. Nanti coba dibantu ditranslate ya.
Okay.
Yang mesti kita pahami adalah punya mood yang naik dan turun itu sebenarnya adalah suatu mood yang kita ngelihat dulu kalau situasinya itu seperti apa. Jadi based on the situation gitu. When you get angry, we must look at the situation. Is it normal or right? Jadi kan ada suatu yang normal in abnormal situation gitu lah. Normal reaction in abnormal situation gitu. Sehingga kita mesti lihat dari itu dulu. Aku mau ujian nih, cemas gitu ya. Ya wajar, siapa sih yang nggak ujian itu cemas gitu. Nah tapi ketika punya perasaan yang ada eksesif ya, mulai mengganggu dan itu terbing terhadap kehidupan sehari-hari, your functioning, your daily life, ya kita mesti harus lebih berpikir bahwa okay, ini kayaknya ada sesuatu deh, something wrong, gitu kan, dengan cara kamu cope, gitu, dengan cara kita cope situasi itu, gitu, sehingga kalau misalkan ternyata sampai mengganggu fungsi, gitu ya, affect to your social functioning, terus habis itu occupational, gitu ya, secara pekerjaan, maka kita harus mencari pertolongan ke expert gitu. Karena ada juga clinical features gitu dari unstable mood atau lability mood itu tadi gitu. Jadi upside down-nya tuh bumping-nya itu agak lumayan ekstrim tuh gitu. Enggak kayak biasanya gitu. Sampai kadang-kadang itu disturbing your judgment gitu. Sehingga kadang-kadang kita enggak bisa berpikir atau kita enggak punya penilaian realita yang baik gitu. Jadi sehingga kita mesti melihat apakah itu sangat mempengaruhi fungsi sehari-hari. Nah, kadang-kadang butuh juga mood stabilizer. Ya, kalau itu memang ada indikasi. Sekali lagi, ketika kamu pergi ke psikiater, kalian pergi ke psikiater, Bapak Ibu semua pergi ke psikiater, nggak harus kasih obat. Kita lihat dulu. Tapi kadang bisa dengan modalitas terapi hanya berdasarkan pada psikoterapi gitu ya. Mungkin itu mindfulness, behavior therapy ataupun dialectical behavior therapy gitu, ada modalities gitu dari penanganan dari manajemen dari psikiatri itu sendiri. Nah tapi kalau misalkan ternyata nggak terlalu berhasil, kan berarti kan ada imbalance neurotransmitter gitu inside your brain, so obat itu perlu diberikan untuk stabilize the unstable or imbalance dari neurotransmitter itu tadi. Sehingga penting untuk kita ketahui kalau kita udah berusaha untuk relaksasi, kita udah berusaha untuk mengelola pikiran kita gitu ya, terus kok itu nggak membaik gitu. Nah, memang harus dibutuh bantuan profesional, dan ada kalanya medikasi itu sendiri itu memang ada tempat gitu untuk diberikan. Kurang seperti itu Mbak Vina.
Oke, terima kasih Dr. Filia. Karifa, we're moving on to the next question ya.
Iya, betul. Yeah, ini okay. Ada yang raise hand nih, Kak.
Iya. Yeah, oke, kita akan terima dulu yang sudah raise hand sejak
betul,
tadi.
Betul.
Oke. Okay.
Dari Kak Mugira ya, Mugira Ternate ya. Silakan yeah. Kak Mugira. Bisa di-unmute.
Hello, Doc.
Hello. Yeah.
I just want to ask to Dr. Trelia.
Yes.
Doctor.
Yes, please.
Could you tell me how to overcome my mental health problem, which is caused by my family or my parents or my people or the people around me? Because we all know that not only parents that having mental health problem, but also their children too. Thank you.
So is it related to your parents or your surrounding actually?
My parents also.
Okay. Yes, we have to explore. It's not only about yourself, it's about your parents, how the parents raise you. We talk about parenting issues here. I don't know exactly about how your parents raise you and how about your parenting, but I think you need to talk about your parents about what you don't like and what you like it. Okay, this is the first one that you need to do. You need to approach to your parents. And the second, if you can communicate to your parents, try to find someone who your parents can respect them and they can hear their advice or anything that they will consider about it. Sometimes we cannot approach our parents because they have their own mindset, because our child or is their property, their own property. So they just want to be a good parents, but maybe they don't know how to adapt to your need as a child. So have you talked to your parents about this issue actually?
Yes, doctor.
Yes, what kind of issue do you have so far? What you have been feeling so far, I mean, what you have been feeling, what you have been thinking, because this is important to get.
Yeah, I
you.
Feel like I have a lot of problems with my just a connection with relation with my family, with my
okay.
parents.
It's only inside your family, or you have a problem in your situation, in your surrounding, besides your family? It's not only to your parents, I mean. Maybe your friend, your best friend, or your relative?
Yeah, doctor.
Okay. We can consider that you have inability to stabilize about your it's hard for you to maintain the relationship, so we can call it as unstable relationship. So I hope that you can find an expert to solve your problem about this, because it will affect to your functioning, especially in how you socialize with other. And it's not only about your parents, it's not only to your parents, it's also your surroundings, especially for your teacher, your friend, or anyone. Okay? Just try it to find out.
Okay, thank you, doctor.
Okay.
Yeah, you're welcome.
Okay, thank you. Thank you very much to Mugira for he's very brave, because he literally said that he have a problem with her parents. Normally when we are having something to discuss about health, about mental health, for example, that is something very, really, really sensitive, right? Sometimes people are shy to speak up. And so thumbs up to the person who just asked questions.
Yes, okay. Right. I really appreciate you, Gila.
We really appreciate it. Okay, Kak Rifa, I'm reading some questions from the chat box, and I think two questions are pretty similar. I'm going to ask this to Coach Raymond, featuring Coach Joe.
Yes.
I will not differentiate. I will not separate them both. So the question is, in Indonesia, I'm going to read quickly first. Dok, kalau misal kita ngerasa bahwa orang-orang di sekitar kita pasti ngejudge akan apapun yang kita kerjakan, sehingga tanpa sadar, apapun yang kita lakukan serasa menjadi beban, merasa menjadi anxious tanpa sebab, dan bagaimana cara menanggulanginya? Ini juga ada yang bertanya lagi, bagaimana jika orang itu, kita merasa orang lain itu selalu menilai setiap tindakan kita, dan itu berpengaruh terhadap kita. So the question is, Coach Raymond and Coach Joe, how to deal with others' judgment? So when we feel like others judge us too much, like it affect us in a not in a good way, so how we deal with that? Because we think like, oh, what will they think about me? What will he or she think about me? Am I doing it right? Am I speaking it right? Am I presenting it right? What will they think about me? So they concern very much about the people's judgment, or maybe they already been judged by others around them. How, what do you think about that? How do we supposed to cope with that? Please, Coach Raymond or Coach Jill, go ahead, please.
I think you have to be confident in yourself, in Allah, and you kind of you can't care about people, their opinions. If you do, you are a slave to their to them. You know, we should be slaves to Allah. Only Allah should matter. Everybody's opinions, it shouldn't matter. So, and I grew up always kind of like make my own decisions. You know, I converted to Islam when I was 15 years old, and my family was like, no, everybody's trying, that's bad, you know, but I didn't care. I was like, this is my life, you know, I'm not you, and this is what's best for me. And a person, if they deep down inside feels this is what's best for me, and you can live with that decision, you know, but if you're following people's opinions, criticisms, you're always gonna be unhappy. So I tell people, just be confident in yourself, and it'd be hard to take the, you know, criticism, but take the punches, and you, and the more you take it, the stronger you become. And then you'll be happier who you are. You know, you can look in the mirror like, you know what, I'm happy with the decision I made, versus succumbing to somebody's opinion and you kind of okay and doing what they say. But that takes work. That is not easy, especially in a social environment. You know, that's why it's important for people to take time to be alone and to know who they are versus everybody else, all the noise.
Oh yeah. So we just have to be smart. Like we have to like able to compartmentalize, like which judgment or maybe which voice or which critic is actually for the sake of ourselves, and which one is actually just a plain mean comments, critics that have nothing to do with our own improvement. What do you think, Coach Joe?
Yeah, that's true. I mean, you know, you have to, I think, you know, whether you're Muslim or not, right? Whatever religion you follow, I think it's important for you to have a good connection to God or Allah or your creator, right? So I think that will help you anchor down to who you are and build your self-confidence. Because when you have a strong foundation, you are less likely to worry about what others think about you, you know? Because like for us, right? For Raymond and I, we're both Muslims, right? We live in America. And you know, it's difficult to be Muslims in America.
Yes.
You know, we believe in Islam, we believe in ourselves, we have to be strong. So even though all those crazy people say things about Islam, but our foundation is strong. So, you know, so we just move forward and be strong with what's in us. Don't worry about the noise. You know, of course you will get it, especially in social media, right? Especially if you're a public figure. You know, when you're a public figure and you have, you know, millions of people on IG following you, no, you're not going to make everybody happy. They're going to be people who say something about you for whatever reason. But you just have to follow your gut, follow your heart, stay solid, and then don't care about the rest. You know, but of course, if it's your parents or your family, of course, you have to care a little bit. Right, because they're your family. But then don't let that control you. Sometimes you have to make a decision that's right for yourself. Like what Raymond said, you know, he converted to Islam when he was 15. So his family didn't like it, but he believed in himself. So I think that is important for you to find that anchor.
Yeah. Also, oh, okay. I have one thing. I used to play basketball. I played overseas and I played in college. And I got thousands, millions of people trying to talk to me. You should be doing this. You should be doing this. You know, coaches telling me stuff. And yeah. I had to learn to like, no.
Athlete.
Yeah.
Athlete environment, athlete world.
Yes. 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 So I had to learn, you know what? I can't listen to all that stuff. I got to focus on the goal, what I do. And the most important voice I learned is like, listen to my voice. I got my coaches and my teammates. Everybody else, I can't listen to, you know, because otherwise I'm not going to be able to play and perform. So I had to learn to be tunnel vision. Focused,
yeah,
because everybody, you can't please everybody. Everybody got something to say, and but yeah. You got to do what you got to do.
Okay. Thank you, Coach Raymond and Coach Joe. Jadi tadi untuk yang menanyakan tadi bagaimana mengatasi orang-orang lain yang merasa bagaimana apa yang harus kita lakukan? Apa yang kita harus lakukan ketika merasa di judge oleh orang yang lain atau kayak merasa ketika orang yang lain itu terlalu menilai kita A, B, C, D, E, so kita harus mempunyai fondasi yang kuat dan kita harus kembali kepada siapakah diri kita sebenarnya dan apa yang sebenarnya ingin kita lakukan. So as long as it is good and it doesn't affect others or hurt others, selama itu nggak melukai diri kita dan orang lain, that's actually very okay. So mohon maaf Karifa dan semuanya sebelumnya, kita akan tetap melanjutkan sesi tanya jawab kita hari ini, but
iya,
unfortunately karena ini udah jam 2 dan Dr. Filia harus ada praktek dengan pasien bersiap-siap untuk aktivitas selanjutnya, so unfortunately, sadly, she has to leave the Zoom first, tapi kita masih akan tetap lanjut di sini dengan Coach Joe dan Coach Raymond. Jadi Dr. Filia, terima kasih sekali atas waktunya, tapi sebelum Coach Filia Coach Filia, I'm sorry. Sebelum Dr. Filia leave the Zoom, mohon share terakhir testimoni dari Dr. Filia. I'm sorry again. Dari Dr. Filia nih, gimana perasaannya setelah bergabung dalam VLC Indonesia dalam acara ini? Bagaimana kesan-kesannya, Dr. Filia? And then you can say bye-bye, maybe see you next time.
Yeah, I do apologize because I'm on duty now at the hospital at duty calls. But I really want to be here till the end of the sessions, but I'm afraid I can do that. But I really appreciate for VLC Indonesia, and it's honored to be here. I really appreciate. We can talk a lot about mental health issues, and I really thanks to the committee, the host, and other speakers like Mr. like Coach Joe and Coach Raymond. Right, so good to be here in one frame with you talk about mental health issue. Thank you so much for the invitation. See you next time. See you next round. Okay.
Yeah. Thank you. Thank
good
you.
Afternoon.
Good afternoon. Bye-bye. We can all say bye-bye to Dr. Filia. Bye-bye, Dr. Filia.
See you.
See you. Okay. Let's move on, Kak Rifa. Next question.
Iya. Saya ambil dari chat, kalau begitu ya.
Sure, yeah.
Okay.
Coach Joe and Coach Raymond, I hope you don't mind. You're going to be handling the rest of the question. But thankfully, luckily for us, there are both of you. So we should be fine.
Okay, ini ada fighting. Pertanyaan. Iya, dari Kemal Pramesta nih, dari Ternate. Nah, di sini bagaimana cara mengatasi overthinking yang berlebihan? Soalnya saya sering berpikir sesuatu terlalu berlebihan. Sebentar. Oh, maaf. Oh ya, betul berlebihan.
That's me.
Oh, oi.
No. I mean that's like me.
Overthinking. Okay. Selalu menganggap orang yang tidak suka semua hal yang saya lakukan. Berpikir mereka membenci saya. Hal itu membuat saya menutup diri dan rasa tak ingin bergaul dengan orang banyak. Bagaimana tanggapannya?
You have to translate that to English. So Coach Raymond and Coach
Joe. Coach Joe Mansour and Coach Raymond. This is question from Kemal Paramesta. How to handle the overthinking? Yeah, because Kemal
overthinking.
Yes. Yeah. Because if they are too overthinking, they tend to be hated. To me, to Kemal, I mean, and it makes him feel that he cross or communicate with many people, and it means that he introvert people. I mean, became introvert. What do you think?
Well, anytime I overthink in general, I try to just move action, you know, because the longer you think about something, the harder it is to act. You know, for example, let's say I want to go for a run, and I give myself 5 minutes to jump and do it. It was more than 5 minutes, you start thinking, you're waiting, and then next you know, your mind starts going in circles. But the only way to combat that is just, you got to do it. You can't just, I mean, the mind is powerful. It gets in our way, you know, but the way to combat that is movement. You got to just do it. it's hard, you know, but the universe acts with movement. It doesn't act with our mind. We think we're doing something with our mind, but we're not. But with your body, you start moving, then you start feeling better. You know, so for another example is a lot of people say, oh, I'm too tired to exercise. Well, you have to start first. And once you get started, then you start feeling better. You get motivated. But if you don't start, you're not going to feel good. But you have to start first and then you start feeling better. You can't think your way to feel better. So the mind is, you got to start. You got to take movement, action.
Yeah. I think I'm sorry, Karifa. I'm going to jump in into this question.
Yes.
I think Kemal is also mentioned that he always overthinking stuff too much, and he always think that everyone, the others, hate him or don't like things that he do, and then he thinks that everybody like simply disagree with him. And that makes him become more like a close person. He became introvert and he doesn't want to hang out with others. So that's the condition. So what do you think about that? Yes.
Yeah, that's tough. It sounds like he wants to please his friends. Mm. You know, how old is the person?
I'm not sure. Kemal Pramesta, if you would like to ask this directly, you are allowed to do so. Untuk Kemal Pramesta,
mungkin bisa
share langsung gitu ya.
Iya, betul. Mm-hmm.
Or not. I think he's a student. Let's say student around high school or university, early 20s.
Yeah, that's tough. That's, you're not social environment.
Early adulthood, you can say that.
Yeah, you want to be cool. You want to fit in.
Yeah.
Oh yeah. So that's the environment. You know, I said that. You know, when you're in high school and college, you want to be cool. You want to be popular and fit in and be with your friends. And again, you have to. You know, I'm an introvert. you know, I'm very in tune with myself. And for extroverts, you know, they probably want to please and make everybody happy. And that's hard to do. And you got to realize you can't make everybody happy. You know, but that's tough. That's tough.
Yeah.
Oh, that's real tough.
I think our previous discussion can somehow answer this situation. Yeah, just find yourself first, like establish yourself first the best way you can, and then after that you can be smarter. You can have more. How do I say? You can grow your mindset. You can grow your mindset on whether you should think about what others think of you or just. Yeah, whatever. I mean, something like that. Okay, thank you. Do we have any more questions? Oh, maaf. Gimana tadi yang pertanyaan Kemal? Karifa bisa bantu. Jadi tadi apa yang sudah dijelaskan oleh Coach Raymond dan Coach Ju adalah?
Ya, mungkin untuk pertanyaan dari Kemal, ya kata Coach Raymond, ya agak susah juga sih ini kalau untuk ini ya, gitu. Betul. Karena kita ini nggak tahu berapa usianya Kemal tersebut. Mungkin menurut Coach Raymond bahwa ya untuk mengatasi overthinking berlebihan, mungkin harus selalu ini ya, harus selalu apa? Dan selalu menganggap semua orang ya harus selalu apa ya
harus menyenangi dia, kayak harus
iya.
Senang dengan yang dilakukan. Dia
betul, harus selalu bersenang
dengan lakukan. That's not doable. Itu susah untuk dilakukan.
Iya, betul.
Yeah, gitu. Okay. Do we continue with the question? Is there anyone who would like to ask? Question.
Silakan.
Yeah, we're nearing the end
iya.
Of the meeting.
Mungkin peserta ada yang mau bertanya lagi, silakan, atau mau mengacungkan, raise your hand.
Alright. So we are going to take two more questions. I see Ibu or Miss or Mrs. Emilia Tupumuri. Hello, Bu Emilia. You can unmute your microphone, please.
Okay, thank you.
Yeah. Where are you from, Bu?
Yeah, I'm from Ambon, Maluku.
Oh, all right. Yes, you can give your question. Hello.
Hello, Ibu.
Halo Ibu, silakan pertanyaannya. Halo? Oh, we lost him.
Okay.
I think I'm going to take another questions from one question from.
Ini sepertinya ada pertanyaan chatbots. Menarik nih, Kak Fina. Ya, di sini dari Ibu Yesi Ari Estiani bertanya how. Okay. For Coach Raymond or Coach Joe, there is a question. There's a student who hasn't healed from his traumatic because he was accused stealing something since the students from junior high school, and how to overcome it. How to overcome the traumatic?
How to overcome trauma?
Yeah.
How to overcome trauma situation?
The trauma situation when he when this person is accused stealing something when he was in junior high.
Trauma. That's hard. You know. That's we all got trauma from our childhood. You know, and that's a whole journey in itself of overcoming these our traumas. And in each case, each person is different, you know, how we handle it and the traumas we deal with in our life, whether it's from our family, you know, where's my friends. I know for me, I grew up in a household. My father was verbally and physically abusive to my mom. I saw a lot of stuff as a kid, and it really traumatized me to the point like I didn't want anything to do with him. My outlet was sports, you know, and school. So I took all that trauma and anger that I had as a kid, and I put it into school and basketball. But at the same time, it kind of, I say it messed me up, but it made me, I wasn't as vocal with my feelings. You know, it wasn't until an adult until I realized you got to talk more about your feelings versus just more just doing things physically. That's how I dealt with my trauma. But each person has to find what triggers them and use it to better themselves in a positive way. Because trauma, we all got it. We all have it, you know, from our childhood. It's just finding that and using in a way to grow and better yourself. I was fortunate that I was able to use that with sports and school. Some people, it's with alcohol and drugs, how they deal with their trauma, which is, you know, not good. But it's important to try to identify that and use it in a positive way, you know.
Yeah, so maybe we don't realize that people around us have their own issues, have their own trauma, but we don't see it. And right. what we see is just they are fine, they look fine, they do everything fine, but we don't know what's happening on he, on her, or his previous life, or his daily, or his at his home. So we just need to realize that everyone have problems. And for ourselves, we just have to find the outlet or how to better. Yeah, jadi jawabannya.
And I want to add that, you know, just like what the doctor said just now, that you know, if you try to do it on your own and you can't, then seek professional help. You know, because yeah, we try to get it done on our own, and if you try and you can't, then it's okay to get help. You know, I know. In a lot of communities in Asia, right? So it's like, if you go to a psychiatrist, you must be crazy. But that's not the case. If you need help, get help.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Baik. Untuk menjawab dari Ibu Yesi, bahwa menurut Coach Raymond, bahwa lakukanlah kegiatan yang positif yang selama dia bisa, gitu. Ya, Bu ya. Nah, dan saran dari Coach Jomansor, carilah bantuan maksudnya secara bisa kalau psikiater atau mungkin yang orang yang bisa membantu menghapusnya trauma seperti itu. Okay.
Yes. Okay. So I think that's all our Q&A session of the day. I realize how this is taking, like, wow, this is taking longer than we expected.
Yes.
Everybody is tired and everything, and everybody will have their own agenda next time. We're still in the weekend, so maybe here Indonesia is still actually in the afternoon, so we can have some naps after this, but maybe in Coach Raymond and Coach Joe mentioned that it's getting late there, so we're very sorry.
It's okay. It's Friday night. It's almost midnight.
Almost midnight.
Wow. Right. Okay. So kita tutup ya, Kak Rifa, sesi tanya jawabnya kita hari ini. Betul, sayang Kak. Sekali ya karena keterbatasan waktu. Terima kasih kepada semua penanya dan telah memberikan pertanyaannya kepada kita semua, dan juga kepada para expert yang telah memberikan jawaban-jawaban yang luar biasa. Sekarang kita akan masuk kepada sesi penutup, di mana kita akan meminta satu orang dari peserta, satu orang aja ya, mungkin like combining testimony ya. So ya, one person have the chance to speak one time and like just give their testimony about the event today. Jadi satu orang, silahkan, kami persilahkan untuk memberikan testimoninya secara langsung. Ini harus secara langsung ya. Siapa? Silahkan Kak Rifas, ada yang ditunjuk?
Mungkin
satu orang aja kali ya.
Satu orang aja ya.
Iya.
Mungkin dari Ibu Ayunati mungkin bisa memberikan testimoninya terhadap
Coach
Romian dan Coach Joe. Uh-huh. Silakan Bu Ayu. Ya, silakan.
You can unmute your microphone.
Bisa di unmute Bu. Nah,
awesome.
Iya, terima kasih. Saya baru pertama kali ikut acara ini. Kebetulan saya dari PPS CPUP Makassar. Sangat senang dengan acara ini ya. Bisa membuka pikiran mengatasi kerumitan dalam kegiatan sehari-hari. Begitu rumitnya perjalanan kehidupan, jadi banyak hal yang mungkin kecil begitu tapi bisa berdampak besar. Dengan acara ini kita bisa mendapat pengetahuan dari Coach Joe
dan Coach Raymond.
Dan Coach Raymond. Terima kasih. Terima kasih juga sudah diajak bergabung. Itu saja, terima kasih.
Baik, terima kasih Bu Ayu.
Okay, next, Kak Rifa, please ask testimony from Coach Raymond and Coach Joe.
Iya.
Go ahead.
Okay, for Coach Raymond and Coach Joe, please give us a testimony to our seminar.
Oh, well, basically, thank you for having us. We had fun. Very interesting topic. It's the language is interesting.
Yeah.
It did. Yeah. It did.
English and Bahasa. So that was interesting. Yeah. But I think the two of you did an excellent job in terms of translating. And Mr. Bako as well. Thank you for having us. I think it was good. And to have the doctor, to get it from the medical standpoint, that was good as well. Do you have something to add?
Thank you for having us, and it just shows you that we are opposite sides of the world, got the same issues and problems here in the States with mental illness and mental health, and just we all got the same problems, but it's humbling, and it's a journey for all of us, but the end goal is to Allah. That's the end goal. Just life is temporary, the pain is temporary, but the end goal is to Allah.
Yes.
Thank you.
All right. Okay. All right, everyone. That just concluded our meeting. We just wrapped everything, and now we're moving on to the closing session. Kami mengundang kepada Ibu Roswita M. Abu, S.Pd.M.A. Beliau adalah dosen dan kepala kantor urusan internasional dari Universitas Khairun Maluku Utara. Tadi penanya pertama kita pada hari ini, Ibu Roswita. Silahkan Ibu Roswita untuk memberikan closing speech untuk menutup acara kita hari ini. Kepada Ibu Roswita, the stage is yours.
Okay, thank you very much everyone. Especially I'd like to give my special thanks to Mr. Bako, the founder of PLC, for having time. And I'm very pleased to have everybody that already joined us today, and especially the special guest from United States of America. I believe that we have maybe 18 or 17 hours difference. So if we are here, we are here Saturday, there's still a Friday. Yeah? So we one day difference between Indonesia and America. But you're still awesome, yeah, to do to present for today's session. And I believe that when we're talking about the mental health, it's not ourselves, it's not bukan diri kita sendiri saja, tapi that's also the role of all the links that connects together. Like for example, family. Ya, ada peran keluarga, kemudian ada peran komunitas, community, our surrounding. That's very important. We connect all together. So it's not ourselves. We have to find the solution for our problem. It's not from ourselves, but everything, every people, yeah, every community, family also taking part in this very good development of our mental health. So what I would like to share here, that if you want to talk about the mental health, it's enough for only 2 hours. So we need special session maybe someday to talk with Coach Raymond and Coach Joe, especially for the exercise. You know, exercise is very important to balance our activity, our daily activity. When we feel like burnt out, then just go and exercise. Do what things that will make us happy. Yeah, something like that. So this is a very good opportunity, and I can thank enough for the PLC to initiate its, this program. And we hope that in the near future, PLC can do the similar things, and especially can choose point or topic that may be interesting for all of us. So we can keep our network, yeah. It is also a good opportunity for us, especially for me, because I can also engage students from Hairi University, Ternate Normaluku, and maybe we can someday will keep in touch with people from all around the world, especially from America. And thank also to Dr. Frilia that already
check. Okay. Hello, everyone. All right. Okay. We're moving on. Kak Rifa?
Iya. Terima kasih, Ibu Roswita. Kami mengucapkan terima kasih kepada seluruh pihak yang telah berkontribusi dalam acara hari ini. Yang pertama, terima kasih kepada para pembicara kita, Dr. Frilia Rahma Putri, spesialis kejiwaan konsultan, Coach Raymond, Coach Joe Mansell, terima kasih dari kami yang tidak terhingga atas waktu yang telah diberikan. Thank you very much.
Selanjutnya kami ucapkan terima kasih kepada seluruh peserta dari seluruh Nusantara and maybe from abroad yang telah hadir dan berpartisipasi secara aktif pada acara hari ini. Mohon maaf jika ada yang belum berkesempatan untuk memberikan pertanyaan atau mungkin sudah memberikan pertanyaan di kolom chat tapi belum sempat terbaca oleh kami. We're very sorry, but we hope there will be another opportunity for us to discuss more about mental health. We'll see what happens next, ya.
Yeah.
Thank you, guys.
Oke, terima kasih juga kepada seluruh supporter team yang telah bekerja keras dan mendukung penuh Zoominar Internasional ini.
And finally, we save this for the last. Thanks to Mr. Bako. Special thanks to Mr. Bako as the founder of VLC Indonesia and his team who give us, Kak Rifa and I, the opportunity to host this event.
Okay, jangan lupa tetap bersama VLC Indonesia. Pantau terus platform sosial media kami di Instagram dan YouTube. Please follow and subscribe it if you haven't already. Before we end this meeting, kami mengundang seluruh pembicara, pengisi acara, tim, dan seluruh peserta yang masih hadir di sini untuk berfoto bersama nih, ya. Mohon untuk menyalakan kameranya. Please turn on your camera, everyone. Okay. Ya, silakan.
So everyone like fixing their clothes and everything, ya. Yeah.
Silakan kameranya diaktifkan yang masih ada. Iya.
Good.
Oke, sudah.
Give the cue, Kak Rifa.
Oke, okay. Yes. Baik, siap ya. 1, 2, 3. Oke, okay. Sekali lagi. 1, 2, 3. Oke, okay. Sekali lagi. Sekali
yeah,
lagi.
We're on the third screen now. Everyone yeah. is turning on the camera. I'm so happy.
Okay.
Kita di screen yang ketiga.
Screen ketiga ya.
Yeah. We have okay. 3 more to go.
3 more to go. Okay. 1, 2, 3.
Okay. Next.
Next. Wah. Okay. Siap ya. 1, 2, 3.
Alright.
Okay. Next. Okay. 1, 2, 3.
Okay.
Last one.
Yes.
Oke, okay, siap nih yang terakhir. 1, 2, 3. Iya, terima kasih semuanya ya.
Awesome, thank you. So that's all for today, everyone. On behalf of myself and Kak Rifa as the host, we'd like to apologize if we made any mistakes during the event. Kami sebagai host mohon maaf jika ada kesalahan atau kata-kata yang kurang berkenan selama kami memandu acara hari ini. Sampai jumpa di lain waktu. Saya Vina pamit undur. Have a nice day. See you next time.
Sampai jumpa di next program. Saya Rifa Rinaldi juga mohon pamit mundur. Stay safe, stay healthy everyone. Sekali lagi terima kasih semuanya. Have a nice day. VLC Indonesia.
One teacher, one book, and one thing can change the world.
Bye-bye.
Okay, bye-bye.
Bye-bye. Wow.
Someone asked for link absensi.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. The attendant list, the attendant list.
Yeah.
So. Daftar hadirnya di grup ya.
Listen to Mr. Bako.
Wow, daftarnya di grup. Bagus banget ya. Thank you.